What exactly is a vBNG? In this video, you will see how virtualizing the BNG is revolutionizing the broadband service. First, let's have a look at what role a BNG plays in a broadband network. A BNG, or a broadband network gateway, acts as the access point for subscribers to connect to the broadband network. And BNG authenticates its subscribers connecting over PPPoE or IPoE. Then, authorize them to establish subscriber sessions so that they can connect to the internet, where they access various services, such as accessing social media, gaming, watching movies, or connecting to their office VPN. During this time, BNG will be sending the subscribers' usage accounting information to the OSS system. BNG systems were traditionally purpose-built devices, and broadband service providers used to buy them in order to set up broadband services and buy more of them when there is an increase in demand. But today, the service providers face a number of challenges that make it difficult to cope up with these legacy BNG systems. They are 1. A sudden increase in broadband traffic. Fact: due to the pandemic, internet services have seen rises in usage from 40% to 100% compared to pre-lockdown levels, and services like video conferencing have seen about 10 times increase in usage. 2. Growing demand for new services, like video streaming, online gaming, and VR applications. 3. Service providers often incur huge operational and capital expenditure associated with service capacity upgrades or addition of new services. Fortunately, as server virtualization technologies have matured for telecom-grade deployments in the recent years, innovators began to rethink how BNG are traditionally implemented in order to cope with the huge growth in capacity demand and reduce costs. And thus, virtual BNG was born. Fact: IHS market poll discovered that 92% of service providers would adopt or plan to deploy vBNG. While a traditional BNG uses a hardware-centric approach, virtual BNG relies on virtualized network functions or VNFs to perform BNG's functions, and runs on general-purpose commercial off-the-shelf hardware. Which means, vBNG replaces purpose-built silicon chips used in traditional BNGs with VNFs or virtualized network functions. In a legacy BNG, new services may require field replacement of components or installation of new devices, which in turn requires additional rack space, power, and trained manpower. But in a virtual BNG, new network services are defined in software components and they run on COTS servers. This innovative approach leads to lower costs, better resource efficiency, and most importantly, avoids vendor lock-ins. Virtual BNG, as it is a new approach from the ground up, adopts new concepts in networking, such as SDN or software-defined networking. SDN helps to build programmable networks and reduce network flow management complexities. In fact, according to International Data Corporation, by 2025, we can expect to see 41.6 billion connected devices that will generate approximately 79.4 zettabytes of data. In this context, virtual BNG can help to build massively scalable, highly flexible wireline broadband services. In comparison with traditional BNGs, virtual BNG can offer more configuration options for customer-centric service delivery, hence service providers can now provide new value-added services, foster innovation, and help drive higher average revenue per user. Now let's see what gives virtual BNG this flexibility. Unlike a traditional BNG, vBNG has its control plane, the part that controls how network packets are being forwarded, and the user plane, the part that actually transfers the data packets, are separated from each other. This process of decoupling the planes is known as CUPS, control plane and user plane separation. CUPS facilitates both the planes to scale elastically as per demand, and hence it can efficiently support the rapidly growing broadband traffic. So, in summary, a vBNG provides the following benefits. 1. It provides a means to build capacity through virtualized network functions. 2. Virtual BNG lets you choose from a range of interoperable virtualized network functions and a wide range of vendors that sell COTS hardware. Hence, service providers can avoid vendor lock-ins. 3. Service providers can now add new revenue-generating services and improve revenue. 4. Service providers can now use SDN to enhance the manageability and automation of their network infrastructure. 5. Virtual BNG's CUPS architecture helps to scale the capacity as per need and protect investment. This is virtual BNG and how it is revolutionizing the broadband services.